Hey, Rembo here, and welcome to my channel. You know, the other day I was watching something by Ryan at Fort Nine, and it was about the fact that apparently we're all running our engines at the wrong RPM, or so that's what they say. So I want to have a little discussion about that right now. So to be honest, you know, I am a fan of the Fort Nine, and I also subscribe. I love to watch the videos. I think they're extremely professional, well put together, and they do a lot of research. And I do put a lot of stock in what they say. And for the most part, I'm on board with this last video. I'm gonna put a link to it above. And that'll be a link to his video so you can see what I'm talking about. It already has hundreds of thousands of views. But I think there's a couple things missing that kind of are important. So let's talk about them right now. All right, let's take a deep dive into this. And again, this is a follow-up to Ryan from Fort Nine's really insightful video on engine RPM. So let's just review a couple of things that he went over. If you didn't see his video, I think this will help. All right, so before we get into nitty-gritty, let's talk about carbon buildup, all right? This is a sneaky phenomenon that occurs when unburned fuel and oil residue accumulate on the engine's pistons and other internal components. Now, over time, this buildup can have some serious consequences, including reduced performance and efficiency. So he talked first about low RPM operations, right? So here's the deal. Running your motorcycle at very low RPMs might seem like a chill ride, but it can actually contribute to carbon buildup. Why? Well, when the engine operates at low RPMs for extended periods, it doesn't generate enough heat and not even enough combustion pressure to effectively burn off those carbon deposits. And this could lead to a layer of gunk building up on your pistons, which can, you know, it's going to rob your bike of its horsepower and overall performance. But then there's high RPM operation. On the flip side, evidence, very good evidence, and he proved that, suggests that pushing your motorcycle towards its upper RPM limit can be a good thing. Why? Because the higher RPMs create more heat and more pressure within the engine, and that helps to burn off those carbon deposits and keeps your pistons cleaner. It's kind of like giving your engine a workout, preventing that carbon buildup from taking hold and, you know, building up on there. All right, so we got to talk about the balance, which he didn't really talk a lot about the balance here, because what he was trying to say was, okay, if you just lug your engine all the time, you're going to lose horsepower. But these things are designed, yeah, you're going to wear it out quicker. So, you know, but it's better than having something that lugs around. I get it. But, well, let's talk about that balancing point, okay? And this is the dilemma: performance versus longevity. Now, running your motorcycle at high RPMs can indeed give you a horsepower boost and keep things cleaner. However, it's important that we have this balancing act, because operating your engine at a constant high RPM can lead to accelerated wear and tear, especially shortening its lifespan. It's like finding the sweet spot between the need for speed and the desire for long-lasting engines, okay? Now, here's some factors to consider. Keep in mind that the optimal RPM range isn't a one-size-fits-all. Different motorcycles have different engine designs, and the intended use also matters. They're, you know, kind of like sports bikes. They're designed for high performance and they might thrive at higher RPMs, while cruisers, they're built for leisurely rides. They may have a different ideal range. I always go back to the bike manufacturer and see what they say and what kind of guidance they give you, all right? How about some additional engine issues that are possible here? Now, here's the twist. Carbon buildup isn't just about pistons. It can affect other engine components like the valves and the exhaust systems. Excessive carbon buildup can lead to poor combustion, increased emissions, and even reduced fuel efficiency. So it's not just about power. It's about maintaining a healthy, efficient engine overall. So there you have it. It, fellow riders, you know, this is the RPM game. It's a delicate balance between power and longevity. Whether you're tearing up the track or cruising the open highway, understand the effects of engine RPM on Carbon Buildup, and that can help you make an informed choice for your motorcycle's performance and health. So there you have it. That's my opinion. Those are the things that I believe we're missing. This is Rembo. Please like, please subscribe. As always, I'd appreciate it. Thank you very much, and have a good day. Bye-bye.